Like, for example, when I always talk about myself, I talk about I have worked every job for Burger King and General Motors. The reason that I say that is to show people that at Burger King, I made $7 an hour. At General Motors, I made over $25 an hour. So I show a progression in my own life. The other thing is, like Mr. Bangy was talking about education, you got 53% of all ex-offenders don't have a high school diploma or GED. Most of them never even had a job. Now they come out here and they pissed off about making $8 an hour, but when we was in prison, we was making $18 a month. And could you miss a day at work, Fred?
No.
If you miss a day at work, you going to the hole. So you gotta have, I let you speak, but you gotta have realistic expectations. See, we try to teach that at Breaking the Cycle to have expectations. I think that's kind of what set us apart a little bit. Like Mr. Bainey was talking about them programs to just run people through just to get the numbers. We have expectations of our clients. That's why when you go through LinkedIn training, we expect you to at least make a post. We expect you to get some more connections because that's what HR people expect you. That's why they don't have a tolerance for some stuff, because it's some stuff that you are expected to know. You expected to know when I say you come into a job readiness class or you go into an interview, you expected to know to put on a shirt with a collar and some slack and some nice shoes. You expected to have a resume. You expected to be able to talk in the right language with the person that you're dealing with. You expected to answer all their questions, and when they say in the interview, do you have any questions for me? You expected to say, I got these questions. You expected to walk in the room like Walter did and introduce himself to everybody in the room because he looked at them on LinkedIn as well as them looking at him. Them are expectations. Right, and and that's what we try to, that's what we got to do ourselves among the ex-offender population, is get people to live up to the expectations to some degree in society, and that'll kind of bridge the gap a little bit too. But that's why I understand the perspective of the HR people, because there are a lot of people that come to me and Mr. Walker and Mr. Bainey with the expectation of, I'm going to give you a job. Exactly. I'm not giving you anything because nothing was given to me. What we teach at Breaking the Cycle is a process. We try to teach you the process to get a job. But I don't own a company. Mr. Bainey don't technically own the company anymore. Mr. Walker don't own the company. We own relationships, and people respect our opinion if I refer somebody to them, but we don't own anything. And just because I refer you somewhere and you don't get a job, don't say, oh, he ain't get me no job.
Right.
You didn't get you a job.
Know